When Jesus is with us, we will cross from death to life. When Jesus is with us, we move from despair to life. When we have Jesus with us, we begin to recognize all that of Jesus begins to move with us. When all that of Jesus begins to move with us, move in us, life becomes different. We read in the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 30 onwards, whom God had foreknown even before their birth on this earth, whom God foreknew. That is the word being used. Can you read that word? Romans 8:30.
And those whom he predestined.
Even you have a destiny, we think. But your destiny is not done by you. Even before you are born, it is predestined by your God for a purpose. You are created for a purpose of God. That's what the Bible says. Whom he predestined,
he also called.
He calls. So whom does he call? He calls whom he has already kept us in our minds. He has kept us in our minds. There's a beautiful song that is sung in Telugu. It says, Kodi tana rekkalanu chapi tana biddalni kapadinatle. నా ప్రభు తన రెక్కల్లో వచ్చి నన్ను కాపాడుతాడు. ఆయన తలంబుల్లో నీ జన్మించుటకు మునిపే ఉండి తిని. ఐ వాస్ ఇన్ ద థాట్స్ ఆఫ్ మై గాడ్ ఈవెన్ బిఫోర్ ఐ వాస్ బార్న్. ఎస్, సో దట్స్ వాట్ ద బైబుల్ సేస్. హూమ్ డస్ హీ కాల్? హూమ్ హీ హాస్ ప్రీడెస్టిన్డ్. Suddenly you come to know the Lord, you come to belong to the Lord. Your brothers, your sisters, other family members, they are not growing like you in the Lord. They are all busy in the worldly works. No, it's not accident. God has fixed his eyes on you and on your family. That's why any trouble comes, any problem comes, you are running around God. You have 101 ways. You can do it, but God doesn't allow that to happen to you because he has kept you as his own. Don't lose courage because of the things that are happening in and around. That's what the Lord says. God is at work in us. The first point God wants us to recognize is God is at work in us. Whom he predestined, he called. Whom he called, he prepared them. That's what the word of God says. You don't take simply milk from the cow and drink. You bring it, even if it is needed, even you mix it with water and you boil it. You kill all the germs. And then if you want, even you cow mix with coffee powder. Whatever things. So there is a process in which the thing that is given to us as a gift of God is being used. In the same way, God is at work in us. And secondly, the God who is at work in us begins to purify us, begin to pull away the germs, begin to kill off. There is a battle that goes on to put a milk in the fire, boiling in the fire, in the heat. It's not a joke. The milk goes through certain change, certain pain, certain struggle. Yes, the same way God is at work in us. The moment God is at work in us, the evil elements, they begin to recognize you and they begin to attack you. Attack you, attack your family, attack your marriage, attack your finance, attack your health, various ways through which. But then, third, the master himself appears on the screen, on the scene. The master himself teaches us what we need to do, and the Lord frees us. So, that's what we read in the book of Ephesians, chapter 3, verse 20. Philippians, chapter 2, verse 13. What we read is, God is at work in us.
Somebody. Philippians 2:13. It is God who is at work in you, enabling you both to will and to work for His good pleasure.
It is God who is at work in you, and God is at work in you for His own pleasure. Praise the Lord.
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 And chapter 3, verse 20.
Now to Him.
Now to Him.
Who by the power at work.
Who by His power at work in you. See, the word says, God is at work in our lives through His power, that His purpose may be fulfilled through you. So God is at work in us, that His purpose may be fulfilled today. It is God is at work in us. It is not that by ourselves we are here. We should recognize this truth. In today's first reading, we find in the book of Genesis chapter 37, Joseph, a young man of 17, was shepherding the flock with his brothers. He was with the brothers, but God called him for a purpose, called Reuben, the elder son, for a different purpose, Judah for another purpose, Levi for another purpose. Different one, everyone are precious to God. We read in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 20. In the great house of God, there are varieties of vessels. Some are made of gold, some are made of silver, some are made of wood, even some are made of mud. It doesn't mean mud is lower value in the eyes of God than that vessel of the gold. That is only for the people of this world. Only the vessel that is made of mud can keep the water, even in the hot summer, outside and inside, cool. And it is that kept for public. Do you keep your golden pot outside? You need 100 watchmen for it. You don't do it. What the mud pot can do, gold pot cannot do it. Because each pot has a purpose. In the eyes of God, there is no one who is big or small. Like Shakespeare says, that life is a play. There are so many small scenes, but there are no small players. When there is supposed to be a screen puller, pulls the screen in the wrong time, what will happen? Gone. A fellow is dead, suddenly he pulled open the screen, that fellow is running around. People will be thinking that previous scene only he died, now he is running around. The whole scene will go away. That's why I say there are so many small scenes, but in the eyes of God, there are no small players. Everyone is precious to God. Everyone is kept in a particular place for a mission, for a purpose of God to be fulfilled. Yes, God is at work in us, and his purpose for which God has kept us where we are, with the body we have, with the talents we have, with the capability we have, with the families of parents who love us, who stand with us. So everything behind that, there is a purpose of God. If you recognize, see, the things that are going in your life, if you had some other parents, they would not have stood with you. But because of your particular parents, their character, God prepares them. Sometimes some men are very, very angry type. They cannot face life. If their children are going through, so God will allow their children to go through in a particular way. If you are going through a struggle or a pain, God will prepare even before you a type of parents. Today the son is somewhere else. So Uncle John and his auntie both pray. They strengthen him, support him. And we know how his life is slowly, slowly shaping, getting shaped. There is a boy there, but God has kept the parents, and to pray for them, to stand with him, to support him, the spiritual power which he cannot get in his life. He can get through his intelligence, he can meet A, B, C, D, he can get money, he can get a job, but something he cannot get, which God supplies through his parents. Yes. So now we find Joseph was with the father, with the brothers. He was in the field. He was not telling, no, I will not go, I will sit out. But God separated him for a purpose. God made him separated for a purpose. And the father loved the boy more than anybody. And the brothers felt jealous of him. The father gave him a beautiful tunic, a garment, which the brothers saw it and they felt, we'll destroy that fellow, we will destroy this cloth. That's why when they saw the boy, first their eyes fell on that dress, pulled it. The power of jealousy, the power of anger, the power of evil will work in our lives. We should not get disturbed or surprised or pained that the evil is at work in us. We need to recognize it, we need to handle it, and we need to cast it away to get back to our equilibrium, to get back to our life of God.